Hey guys, Tyler Jeffcoat here from Seller Accountant, and today I want to talk about overhead. How do you understand if you're fat as a company or if you're running a lean operation? And if you suspect that you might have too much overhead, how would you go about figuring out if you really do and what do you do about it? And so let's talk about a couple of things here really quickly. So this is our kind of pie chart of kind of average Amazon dominant seller performance. And as you can see here, the normal, this is a P&L kind of stated as a pie chart. The bottom half of this P&L, your FBA fees, your commissions, your advertising, that's all Amazon, right? For the average seller, you're giving a lot of your hard-earned money to Amazon, but you're happy to do it because Amazon solves a lot of your problems operationally. They make you a lot more effective as an operator. And so you might have a third in your product COGS, and then you're hopefully going to keep 10 or 12% in profit. But the one I want to bring your attention to that we really never talk about is overhead. Amongst the entire population that we study, we're going to have the new study come out here in about a month or two, so stay tuned for that. But from the old kind of 2019 data, of every P&L we looked at, it was about 12% was in everything that isn't advertising, isn't logistics, isn't commissions, isn't product COGS, right? Like all the other expenses. And so what kind of expenses might be considered overhead in your business? Here's just a couple, you know, things like salaries. I mean, bodies are a big part of your overhead. Are you paying contractors? Do you have your buddy doing the work for you? Do you have employees? Are they full-time employees? Are you paying yourself as the owner a salary? That could be a part of your overhead. Software, whether it's e-commerce support tools or the kind of dues and subscriptions for something like a Gmail or, you know, that kind of thing, that's actually overhead. Any location related expenses, let's say, for instance, you got to pay rent or office expenses, keeping coffee in the coffee maker, that kind of thing. And then, you know, a lot of times you might have outsourced partners. I see a lot of consulting, whether it's marketing consulting or getting my business ready to sell consulting, or maybe instead of hiring an accountant as an employee, you can save some money by hiring a firm like Seller Accountant to be your outsourced accounting partner or CFO partner. But these are the kinds of things that tend to make up a lot. Actually, one that I'll add to this, depending on how you capture your expenses, outbound shipping. If you have a non-marketplace, like you're selling to a Shopify customer and you have your shipping from FedEx or UPS, that outbound shipping may also be overhead. Just depends on how you capture it. So let me show you an example from several months of one of our clients. So we've picked a random set of months here so that it's not identifiable who this is, but let me just walk you through this example. And I'm going to tell you why I use this example. So there, you can see their Amazon sales, Shopify sales, got some customer direct sales and some wholesale, but they're 91% Amazon dependent. Then their cost of goods sold. So this $736,000 here is inclusive of their pick and pack fees or Amazon commission. I kind of zipped it up, but this is a total cost of goods sold factor for this client. And their gross profit over this series of months is, you know, about 50%. And then what you hear me talk about a lot as the CFO is PAG. What is their post-advertising gross profit? And for this seller, you subtract a fairly large advertising budget, larger than we would like to see. But you know what? They've got such great margins in the product that they're kind of okay because their PAG, this 49.75% gross profit minus the 26 points they're paying in advertising, leaves them with a 23.5% or 23.65% PAG. The reason I picked this example is that 23.5% or 24% is actually pretty much average, what we saw across almost all private label sellers. And so this is a fairly average margin after advertising, but then we lost a bunch of money over these few months, right? 160 grand lost. We had a 10%, 11% loss. And so the question is, and this might be where you are, if you're worried about your overhead, is what's killing me? I know something's killing me. What's killing me? And so what I would recommend doing is look at your P&L. I mean, the first thing is you have to actually have an accounting system that's helping you answer the question, what did I really spend during this last period on dues and subscriptions? Okay, we spent $25,000 for this client. What did I really spend on e-commerce support tools? Okay, I spent $55,000. I got to be able to answer those questions with integrity. I need to have some kind of a bookkeeping system that I can trust. But then I want to just kind of set my P&L up and have these percentages pop up along the right-hand side. And I want to go hunting. I want to go hunting for percentages that are larger than 1 or 2%. Obviously, this particular business is requiring a tremendous amount of payroll expenses. You can see down here at the bottom, almost 15% of their entire P&L is going towards their payroll. Now, if you had a lot more margin in your products after ads, again, 24% is not bad, but it's not 40% after advertising, right? Maybe you could afford to pay this kind of overhead and payroll, but I would argue, oh boy, this is probably public enemy number one. This is a brand owner that probably needs to take a look at their at how they're managing their warehousing and their teammates. Now, their second largest expense is this outbound shipping expense here that you can see. It's about $55,000 or almost 4%. Now, that's another one that's big. And this is another thing that's kind of evidence, if we're kind of hunting here, this is evidence that their warehousing and the expenses that go along with shipping the products, you know, I mean, you can see here during the same period of time, we only did 106,000 Shopify sales, plus some customer direct sales. But my goodness, having 56,000 outbound shipping, there may be something to look at. Can we renegotiate our shipping rates or rebox our products? Do we have a clear org chart? Do we have people that are really doing the core key functions for a business? Can we fix shipping? So those are the first two. And then I want to keep going. I mean, when I look at these expenses that I would say are kind of related to having people in the office, right? I've got meals and entertainment where I'm going to buy food. And I've also got office expenses, which are, you know, keeping the lights on, keeping internet at the office. Those again are pretty big expenses that for this particular brand owner are basically tied up in the fact that I went big. I got a big warehouse. I hired a bunch of people and maybe my volume didn't quite go up as much as I hoped it would. And now I'm bleeding, right? Now, the other category that I have up here that's also circled in red are your software tools. So there's kind of two different categories of software tools that we use here at Seller Accountant. The top one here called dues and subscriptions. And we kind of call that anything general. If I'm paying for Adobe or for Screencastify, if I need to have a Zoom, you know, or my Gmail, those kind of general expenses, Microsoft Office, they might go in dues and subscriptions. But if they're tools that are specific to gaining business intelligence for e-commerce, this could be your inventory management tool or something like a Seller Labs or Helium 10 or Sellix. Those are the kind of tools that are going to go into a separate account called e-commerce support tools. But let's be clear, these are basically all software tools, right? And for this seller, we've got 5% total here in software. Now, that's probably a little bit high. And so what you would want to do is in your accounting system, click into one of these and say, huh, oh, wow, I'm buying Sellix and Tika Metrics and Managed by Stats and, you know, Seller Labs and Helium 10. I'm buying seven products do the same thing. Why don't I find a couple that I can get rid of that I'm not actually getting value out of? Or I'm paying for three, you know, this is like an embarrassing story, but we realized we were paying for like three different email systems at one point. We had dumped Microsoft 360 and transitioned to Gmail, but we had left an old Gmail account open. And we just had to realize, wow, we were wasting a few hundred bucks a month. You might be amazed if you just go in and carefully review each of your expenses. You may be amazed at what you can cut. And so at the big picture here is just a reminder, overhead is something we've got to be very careful to keep low in our businesses as sellers. And if you feel like your overhead's kind of out of whack, you got to do a kind of a detailed analysis of what's actually on your P&L over a few months and find the fat. Let's find where we are spending money that isn't directly generating value for our bottom line. You know, for instance, research and development is another one that can pop up here as an overhead. This might be really critical for our business. If we're a business that's turning out brand new products that are really innovative, spending a lot of money on R&D makes a ton of sense. But if we're not, we just need to be careful and make sure that our profit goals are being reached with our current spending strategy. And to be honest with you, for most sellers, this is just a matter of making yourself, and this is what I'd like to challenge you to do if you happen to watch this video, make yourself spend 20 minutes, pull up your profit and loss for several months. You don't want to do one isolated month and look, hunt and peck for those percentages that are more than 1-2% down below the line and dig in, click on those transactions and say, oh, I didn't realize I was paying for four of those. Go renegotiate stuff. Really see if you can cut some of those core expenses. And I think you'll be a lot happier if you do that. Have a great day. Take care, guys.